Hello students, today let us discuss about Swern oxidation reaction. See, in this method alcohol is treated with a specified oxidizing agent, that is DMSO. What is DMSO? Dimethyl sulfoxide, and that is followed by the addition of oxalide chloride and triethylamine, shortly it is given ET3N, triethylamine. Okay, so how the reaction takes place, let us see. Where you look at the equation, whatever is given in the page number 117, propane 2-ol is taken, that is the secondary alcohol, propane 2-ol, and dimethyl sulfur oxide, this is the structural formula for dimethyl sulfur oxide, and oxalyl chloride, there are two chlorine atoms are bonded with two carboxyl group, that is oxalyl chloride, in the presence of triethylamine. So here how you have to make the cleavage in such a way that the two hydrogen atoms should be removed from this one. At the same time, you have to remember the concept CHOH, that is a secondary alcoholic group, always on oxidation it changes into CO. Therefore, here the propane 2-ol, that is the secondary alcohol, that is converted into the ketone, that is propanone. So here you can how the conversion takes place. You see here the CHOH from the reactant converts into C double bond O, ketone group, therefore the product is directly formed. And in the another next reactant, from the next reactant, CH3 twice S is eliminated. Okay. And from the third reactant, oxalyl chloride, one CO is eliminated, and another one CO with this oxygen, it changes into carbon dioxide. And from the alcohol, the two hydrogen atoms removed with these two chlorine atoms and converts into 2HCl. So this is the equation, how to write the equation for this reaction. It's very simple one, but you have to remember how the elimination takes place from each one reactants and how the product is formed. Only one thing you have to remember, it always the secondary alcoholic group on oxidation, it gives ketone groups. So that is very important one. And here the oxidizing agent used is what? DMSO. What is DMSO? Dimethyl sulfoxide. And this oxidation is called as Swern oxidation. Okay. And next one, catalytic dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation means removal of hydrogen. Dehydrogenation is what? Removal of hydrogen. So in the removal of hydrogen, it takes place in the presence of the catalyst, that is copper, at the temperature 573 Kelvin. Here you have to remember this one, from the primary alcoholic group and secondary alcoholic group, if it undergoes catalytic dehydrogenation, primary alcoholic group CH2OH, so from that one the H2 is eliminated, so remaining is what? CHO. So it gives what? Aldehyde. And from the secondary alcoholic group, the what? Two hydrogen atoms are removed in this way, therefore it gives what? Ketone group. So this, additionally you have to write these two steps in your textbook, then only it is very easy for you to study. Okay. And here you see there are two examples are given. First one is primary alcohol and another one is secondary alcohol. So I rounded here how the hydrogen atom is removed from ethanol, and finally it gives what? The aldehyde. You compare the concept whatever I explained just now. Okay. Then you will get the product ethanol. Ethanol. Try to understand the difference between ethanol and ethanol. Ethanol is, that is the alcoholic group, and ethanol, that is the aldehyde group. Similarly, the secondary alcohol, when it undergoes catalytic dehydrogenation, so the two hydrogen atoms from the primary secondary alcoholic group, it is removed and it gives what? Ketone. Whereas the tertiary alcohol, it undergoes dehydration in the presence of copper and 573 Kelvin. So underline this step. Okay, dehydration, not dehydrogenation, dehydration. What is dehydration? Removal of water. So for that, just you expand the structure in this way. So one methyl group I expanded in CH2 and hydrogen. So then I can easily show that how the water molecule is removed. So after the removal of water molecule, it forms an alkene. Alkene is what? That is 2-methyl-propionyl. So in the catalytic dehydrogenation, so in the summary, you have to remember these 2 points. Primary alcohol group, it converts into aldehyde. Secondary alcohol, it converts into what? Ketone. Tertiary alcohol, it does not undergo dehydrogenation in the presence of copper at 573 Kelvin, whereas it undergoes dehydration in the presence of copper at 573 Kelvin. It gives an alkene. Okay, so this is another one important method to differentiate the primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol. Already two methods I explained to you. One is Lucas method and another one is what? Victor Mayer's test. Okay, so now next one, a reaction of glycol. Glycol, the first paragraph, in the wordings, so the equation, the reactions are given, but I written that explanation in the equation. See, when ethanol is treated with an halogen acid, the two hydroxyl groups of the glycol is treated with an halogen acid, the two hydroxyl groups are replaced by two halogen atoms, then it forms what? Dibromoethane. Similarly, if glycol is treated with PCl5, then two OH groups are replaced by two chlorine atoms. Here, the glycol, it contains only primary alcoholic group. There is no secondary alcohol. What is the meaning of primary alcoholic group? CH2OH is what? Primary alcoholic group. CHOH is what? Secondary alcohol. So in the glycol, it contains two primary alcoholic group. Okay, at the same time, the second line, it is given, it reacts with metallic sodium to give monosodium glycolate. But that is written in the equation this way. Glycol, when it is treated with metallic sodium, in the first step it gives monosodium glycolate. How do you write the monosodium glycolate? It's very simple. From one primary alcoholic group, hydrogen, it is replaced by sodium, that's all. Remaining all same only, the structure from the glycol structure, only one hydrogen atom is replaced by one sodium in the first step. Whereas in the second step, say from the second alcoholic group, second primary alcoholic group, one hydrogen atom is replaced by one more sodium. Therefore, it gives disodium glycolate. So, this equation, it is shortly, it is given in wordings in the first paragraph. But you have to understand through this equation. Okay. So, next one, see, when glycol is treated with phosphorus triiodide, initially it gives what? Diiodo 1, 2 diiodoethane, but this is highly unstable. Therefore, the two iodine atoms are eliminated as iodine molecule, then again it gives what? An alkene. This is very, very important question for 2 marks. So, what is the reaction between glycol and a phosphorus triiodide? With phosphorus triiodide, otherwise hydroiodic acid, it gives alkene, not haloalkene. Alkene is the final product, that only you have to write. Okay. And next one, see, when glycol is heated with nitrating mixer. Nitrating mixer, already I explained to you what is the meaning of nitrating mixer. Mixer of sulfuric acid and nitric acid. Mixer of concentrated sulfuric acid and corn nitric acid is what? That is the nitrating mixer. And here you have to write the equation this way. Nitric acid, I have two molecules of nitric acid. I have written like that, HONO2, and here HONO2. It is then only you can easily remove the water molecule from the glycol. So one water molecule is eliminated in this way, and another one water molecule also eliminated. So what is left out? CH2ONO2. And what is left out here? CH2ONO2. So it is very simple to find out the answer, otherwise the product. So try to write down the equation in this way. So you have to remember this one, how to write the elimination of water. For that only I expanded the structure of nitric acid in this way. Okay, and the final product formed is 1, 2 dinitroxyethane. ethene is given, not ethene. Okay, that dinitroglycol is formed, and you have to underline.